Yo, what's going on everyone? Thank you again for stopping by in today's video. This is a special video as well. We're going to go over the new animals from the Southeast Asia DLC. I got an early key for the DLC itself, sent over by Frontier, the kind folks at Frontier. So I'm able to have an extra couple of days to check out the animals, new enrichment items, etc. So that's what we're going to go over in this video. So right now we're going to focus solely on the animals that are being placed in the enclosure. So we're not going to take a look at the giant leaf insects. Only the animals for inside an enclosure. So let's get started, shall we? So the first animal we're going to check out is the Malayan tapir. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly. It's an endangered species as well, with an estimated population in the wild of 3,000. And these tapirs live in the rainforest of Southeast Asia. They measure between 1.8 and 2.5 meters in length and weigh between 250 and 540 kilograms. The tapirs are endangered, and the main threat towards the species' habitat loss is through deforestation and conversion of land for agricultural use. The minimum habitat requirements for the tapirs are a traversable area of 430 square meters. They don't have a climbing need, of course, and the swimmable area is around 37 square meters. They live in a temperature ranging from 6 Celsius to 42 Celsius, so you don't really have to worry about heaters slash coolers that much. And in terms of group size, they can live from 1 to 2 animals, so one male, one female. So you can't have a massive group in Planet Zoo. The relation with humans is neutral, so you don't really have to worry about stress levels, and the guest cannot enter the habitat. The life expectancy of the tapirs are around 30 years. The tapirs can also share the enclosure with a binturong, the Bornean orangutan, Indian elephant, and the proboscis monkey. So the next animal on our list is the babirusa. Once again, hopefully I pronounced it correctly. It is a vulnerable animal with an estimated population in the wild of around 10,000. The babirusa is a species of pig native to the Sulawesi Islands of Indonesia and several small surrounding islands. They're mostly hairless with gray skin, and the male babirusas have 4 tusks that curl back towards their skull. They have a head body length of 85 to 110 centimeters and a tail length of around 30 centimeters. The male babirusas weigh between 70 and 100 kilograms, and the females are around 45 to 80 kilograms. The babirusas are a vulnerable species due to overhunting for its meat and habitat loss as well, unfortunately. In Planet Zoo, the babirusas need around 290 square meters of traversable land with no swimmable area whatsoever. The temperature they like to live in is between 13 Celsius and 42 Celsius. So once again, you don't really have to focus on heaters at all. The group size is between 1 and 5, that is 1 male and up to 4 females. They're confident in relations to humans, so once again, you don't have to focus on the be quiet signs that much. And the guests are not able to enter the habitat. And the life expectancy of the babirusas are around 18 years. Personally, I like the look of these babirusas a lot, especially the male with those 4 tusks, especially the ones that are sort of curling backwards towards their skull. Looks super cool, and the details on them, very nice. Up next we have the binturongs. They are a vulnerable species as well, and the population in the wild is unknown. The Binturong, also known as a bear cat, is a species of mammal that lives in the forest of South and Southeast Asia. They have wiry black hair with a brown face and white-tipped rounded ears. The females are approximately 20% larger than the males, and the Binturong has a head body length of 71 to 91 centimeters and a tail length of 65 to 91 centimeters. The males weigh between 9 and 20 kilograms, and the females weigh between 11 and 32 kilograms. The Binturong is threatened by habitat loss, degradation, and fragmentation through deforestation. Its population has declined by 30% since the 1980s. The Binturong is a protected species in Bangladesh, Thailand, Malaysia, and Vietnam. The minimum habitat requirements are around 182 square meters of traversable land and around 40 square meters of climbing space. They live in temperatures around 13 Celsius and 42 Celsius. So once again, heating is not an issue. The group size in Planet Zoo, they can live in groups of 2 to 5 animals, that is up to 5 males and up to 5 females. They're shy relations to humans, so you have to place a couple of those be quiet signs to help the stress levels to go down faster. The guests can enter the habitat, so you can make a nice walkthrough enclosure. And the life expectancy is around 22 years. The Binturong can share an enclosure with the Malayan tapir and the sun bear. Next up, we have the dhole. The dhole is an endangered species as well, with an estimated population in the wild of around 2,500. The Ussuri dhole lives in the forest, grasslands, and tundra of India, Nepal, China, Bangladesh, Myanmar, and Thailand. It is the largest of all subspecies of dhole. The Ussuri dhole has a red coat, wide underbelly, and a narrow muzzle. The dhole has a head body length of 88 to 113 centimeters, a tail length of 41 to 50 centimeters, and a shoulder height of 45 to 55 centimeters. Both the male and female are similar in size, but the males are significantly heavier than the females. The males weigh between 15 and 20 kilograms, and the females weigh between 10 and 13 kilograms. The dhole is an endangered species, and in recent years, its range has decreased. The dhole is often seen as a pest, and it can and does kill livestock. The population has also been introduced to novel diseases through domestic dogs. Additionally, the deforestation has destroyed and fragmented their habitat and reduced prey availability. The dhole is now a protected species in India, Russia, Cambodia, Vietnam, and Laos. The minimum habitat requirements in Planet Zoo are around 1160 square meters of traversable land, and they live in temperatures varying from 3 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. The group size in Planet Zoo where they can live in is quite big, varying from 2 to 25, and that is 25 males and up to 13 females. The relations with humans are confident, and the guests cannot enter the habitat. The life expectancy is around 13 years. Personally, I really like these dholes. They will definitely be added to the zoo itself. They have a very distinct look as well. And once again, they look super cool, so a definitely add-on in my personal zoo. And up next we have the sun bear. The sun bears are vulnerable and the population in the wild is unknown. The sun bear is a small species of bear that lives in the tropical rainforest of Southeast Asia. It has a dark brown to black fur with a yellow tan face and muzzle, with a distinctive orange-colored crescent marking across their upper chest. The sun bear has a broad head, long oblong snout, and small rounded ears. Males and females look the same, but the males are 10% to 20% larger than females. They measure between 120 and 150 centimeters in length and weigh between 27 and 65 kilograms. The sun bear is a vulnerable species. It is mainly threatened by habitat destruction through deforestation and agricultural land conversion, often to create palm oil plantations. Although the current population of sun bears is unknown, it is thought that their numbers have decreased by 30% in recent decades. Many of the areas they live in are protected, but illegal deforestation still occurs. The minimum habitat requirements in Planet Zoo are around 920 square meters of traversable land and around 60 square meters of climbable space, with a frying temperature between 6 Celsius and 42 Celsius. The group size in Planet Zoo is small. They can only live up to 1 to 2 animals, and that is 1 male, 1 female. Their relation with humans is neutral, and the guests are not able to enter the habitat. The life expectancy of sun bears is around 28 years. And the sun bears can live together in one enclosure with the binturong. Up next we have the proboscis monkey. They're endangered as well, with an estimated population in the wild of around 7,000. The proboscis monkey is a species of primate that lives in the rainforest, mangroves and swamp forest of the Isle of Borneo. The monkeys have a dark orange fur on their backs and the top of their heads, paler orange fur on their chest, stomach and upper arms, and grey fur on their lower bodies, legs and forearms. Males have a distinctive elongated nose that hangs down over their lips. The females do not have this pronounced feature, although their noses are still quite prominent for primates. Males and females differ in size, with males being an average height of 66 to 76 centimeters and weighing between 16 and 22.5 kilograms. The females measure between 53 and 62 centimeters in height and weighing between 7 and 12 kilograms. The proboscis monkey is endangered mainly due to the amount of deforestation that occurs to create oil palm plantations on the island of Borneo. Their habitat is protected in some areas, but deforestation is still occurring at a rapid pace, often illegally. The minimum habitat requirements in Planet Zoo are around 400 square meters of traversable area and around 30 square meters of climbable areas. The temperature they live in is around 17 Celsius and 42 Celsius. The proboscis monkey also lives in a fairly big group, frying from 3 to 19 animals, and it is 9 males up to 18 females. They're confident in relation with humans, and the guests cannot enter the habitat. Their life expectancy is around 21 years. The proboscis monkey can share the enclosure with an Indian elephant and the Himalayan tapirs. And the proboscis monkey is also a master of performing aerial moonwalks, as you can see on your screen right now. And then the last animal of the showcase will be the clouded leopard. They are a vulnerable animal with an estimated population in the wild of 10,000. The clouded leopard is a medium-sized cat that lives in the forest and grassland of Southeast Asia. It has yellow to gray fur that is covered in large black rectangular rings. Their head, legs and tail are covered in black spots and stripes. Clouded leopards are between 69 and 108 centimeters long, with a tail length of 61 to 91 centimeters. The males are larger than females. The clouded leopards weigh between 11 and 23 kilograms. The clouded leopard is a vulnerable species. Its population is largely fragmented across its range due to habitat destruction by deforestation. This reduces the amount of habitat and prey that the leopards have access to, and also decreases their choice of mates. The leopards are being researched to better understand how they mate and reproduce. And there are many facilities that have entered into the captive breeding programs in order to conserve the clouded leopard. The minimum habitat requirements in Planet 2 is 530 square meters of traversable area and around 80 square meters of climbable space. They live in temperatures varying from 6 Celsius to 42 Celsius. The group size they can live in Planet 2 is from 1 to 2 animals, and that is 1 male, 1 female. They're shy with relations to humans, so once again, those be quiet signs are a must. The guests are not able to enter the enclosure. The life expectancy is around 15 years. Personally, the leopards are my favorite animal from this pack, so they will definitely receive their little place in the zoo. Just the overall look of the leopard, it looks awesome. Really nicely done in terms of visuals as well. So, can't wait to use them in the zoo. And with the clouded leopard showcased as well, that brings us to the end of the video. All the edibles in general look very nice. Visuals are great. Also got over a couple of enrichment items of this video, so check them out myself. There is a quick note on the bint rung though. A lot of folk from the Planet Zoo community gave some critique or some comments about the looks of the bint rung. And Frontier is going back into the studio to check the look of the bint rung out, and they are changing it. So the footage that you've seen in this video is not the final look that the bint rungs will have. So stay posted on Twitter. Also follow Frontier and Planet Zoo, of course, because they do give us more updates along the way of the DLC itself. So they will most likely come up with a screenshot whenever it's finished. But the look that you've seen in this video is not the final look in the DLC. For now though, I want to thank you once again for checking out this video. It was very fun to make. And once again, Frontier, thank you very much for sending a early key over to me so I'm able to create this video. And yeah, that is pretty much it. So once again, thank you very much for checking out. Stay safe. I will see you all in the next video. Stay cool. Bye-bye.